All right, we'll try to do a little bit of, it won't be the daily Zohar, but we'll be try to understand the whole concept of the Mishkan in relation to the Egel as the Ari brings it, as the Kabbalah views that. So in order to do that, we need to look first of all at the Egel and to see what the Erev Rav tried to do when it was when they built the Egel. So you guys are guessing, Yei Nan HaEgel, the issue with the Egel, with the golden calf, we have to know the intention of the Erev Rav. What was the reason when they provoked the Jews to do the Egel? And it says, Vayakam Melech Hadash al Mitzrayim, when a new king came on Mitzrayim, the Ari says, I already spoke to you the whole issue about Bil'am Ve'inyan. Erev Rav, and to know what the Erev Rav is, again, this is Aliba that they are in, I don't know if you're going to get to the whole thing today, just like touch bases, is the leftovers, the that was left from the Neshama of Moshe Rabbeinu, that's the Erev Rav came. It's like the sawdust when you have wood. So the sawdust, that's what the Neshamot of the Erev Rav came. And it says, that's one of the reasons why Moshe Rabbeinu was so eager to bring the Erev Rav into Am Yisrael, because he wanted to save those neshamot and actually to fix them up and bring them back to the source in which they was. And it says, but still there was Nitzasot Kedusha in them, therefore he was trying with all his effort to bring them tachat kamfei Shechina, and it was the same thing that happened with Bil'am. Bil'am, we say, lo kam b'Yisrael Moshe, Navi ke Moshe od, in the Jews there was not a prophet like Moses, but in umot ha'olam, in the nations, was, as the Gemara says, and then who was that? There was Bil'am. Bil'am, it says, the Ari says, already explained to you when it refers to Rachel stealing those trafim from her father, ki Lavan ha'arami, Lavan, nidgalgel be-Bil'am ben Be'or, became a reincarnation of Bil'am ben Be'or, ki Be'or u'bno shel Lavan, because Be'or was the son of Lavan, ve'aviv shel Bil'am, and the father of Bil'am. Ve'ine kol otam mishpacha, the whole entire family is from one shoresh, as we said, which are the remnants of the neshama of Moshe Rabbeinu. Let's call it the sawdust of Moshe Rabbeinu. And then who are these? Lavan, Ube'or, Ubilav, and Bilam's sons, Yunus and Yombrius. And it says that each and every one of them was already a big magician and a big kosem, and that's exactly what it was. So what happened was when Bnei Yisrael came out of Mitzrayim, they took this golden plate, when it says Ale Shor, and they threw it in the ocean, and it was a Shem, one of the names, it says Ale Shor, and the casket of Yosef rose up, and as we were able to take it. So when they made the fire for the Egel, Aaron took it, and he threw it in. They threw this thing inside, and then Ala Shor, and this the Shor came about. It says Ale Shor, rise ox. That's where it came about. And it says, what the reason why to do so, because Be'or, Aviv Shel Bil'am, the father of Bil'am, Hayam Megulgal Betzomeach, reincarnated, again, this is according to the Ari with reincarnations, was Megulgal Betzomeach, was reincarnated into a living, into a plant, into a plant form. And they wanted to do to bring it up, right? And he didn't have yet the zchut to be elevated into a level of a chai, and because there was so much zohama, so much filth in it, he couldn't rise himself up. It was still impure. When the impurities come, he goes from one level up to another, one level up to another. So how did they do so? So they look at the magics, they threw this plate out, and then the ox came. And the nefesh, the soul of Be'or, was in that ox, in that golden calf. And he was used to scream and says, Elo Elokecha Israel, this is your God Israel. So therefore, in other words, he was talking. And that's what it says also in Tehillim. And it says that they gave him grass to eat. And it says in Tehillim, Ketavnit Shor Ochel Esev, as an image of a bull, of an ox eating grass. But that's what happened. There was magic, and all of a sudden there was grass. And the golden calf came, and there was this tremendous experience where he came and he actually ate grass. You see this golden calf, you know, calf eating grass. That's what it says in Tehillim, Psalms Kuf Vav 106, and that's what he's referring to. And why was it eating that? To remove from there his neshama, to be able to elevate it and to bring it up into a level of a chai. So that was the problem. Now, the problem was that Aaron sinned, and now whoever needs to fix it is Moshe. Moshe needs to fix it. And it says that Vayakel Aaron, right? And Aaron gathered. And now it says, Lefishe Moshe Ayam Mebchina, Moshe was supposed to fix that, this one, because it says, since they were chote in the Egel, Sheneimar Vayakel Ha'am El Aaron, and the people gather on Aaron to make them a golden calf, Lefishe Chat'u Be'ele, Sheneimar El Elokei Israel, El Echa Israel. This is your God, so therefore there was this sin. Kenegdo, against that, Baletaken, Moshe came to fix that, right? And how? Sheneemar vayakel Moshe et kol adat b'nei Yisrael. So they gathered for dvar avera. Now they need to be gathered ledvar mitzvah. And that was the tikkun in which they needed to do. And what was the tikkun? What was the need to fix? They need to fix two things that could be weighed and compared against the whole entire Torah. For example, Shabbat. Kol mi sheshomer Shabbat, kilu kiyem kol haTorah kula. If you kept Shabbat, it's like you fulfilled the whole entire Torah. V'chen asiyat haMishkan. And so is building the Mishkan. Was like doing the whole entire Torah. That's why it was 6 days of Miluim. 7 days of Elohim, he built it, took it apart, and then in the eighth day it stays, because this is the damage you did here, the eighth day he built it one more time, and that was the end of that. And it's just hard for me to see. All right. And it goes like this. Inyan vayomer Moshe ra'u ha'am, ra'u kara Hashem b'shem Betzalel. Inyan re'iya, that what we are talking about, re'iya, שאמר ראו הכוונה לפי שהיה קשה בעיניהם לאמור. It was very hard for them to say that. Because by the Mishkan, it says, how is it possible by building the Mishkan, we're going to overcome the damage, the chet in which we did by the Egel? How is it possible? But, it says, אלא בצלל, בן בנו של חור, who is going to build it? שקרא השם בשם בצלל. הקדוש ברוך הוא קורא להם בצלל. Who was בצלל? He was the grandson of Hur. Hur was the other person who we mentioned last week that they killed because they were the two quote-unquote babysitters, Aharon and Hur. When Hur came and confronted Am Israel, what are you guys doing? They killed them. So therefore, how would be the tikkun that his grandson would build the Mishkan? There would be the fix-up. So it says, Ben Beno Shechu Sharaktim, Al Shelo Asa Et HaEgel, Baze Yeh Lachem Bufet. That's going to be a sign for you that this is your kapara. Ki Bemaaseh HaMishkan Itkaper Lachem Avon HaEgel. By building the Mishkan, the sin of the golden calf would be atoned for you. Why? Kevan Shekategor Nasa Sanegor. The persecutor become a defense lawyer. That's how it's going to work. Lachen Lo Yeches Betzalel Ela Ad Chur. That's why it referred to Bezalel in lineage all the way up to Hur, not further than that, because the whole purpose is that. Lo pachot velo yoter, no more, no less. Leorot lahem, to show them, shehu mizaro shel Hur, that he is a descendant of Hur, leyot sanigor ala kategor. to speak on behalf of them on the crime that they committed. Why? ולפי שהזהב עשו לעגל, since they made the golden calf with gold, בכל מעשה מלאכת המשכן, זהב תחילה. When it refers about building the Mishkan, has to be זהב, has to be gold. Gold was fixed. So you see from here, gold, gold. Now how it has to be? It has to be זהב טהור, pure gold, without any alloys inside. Because the alloys, spiritual alloys, is what caused Am Yisrael to sin. That was the Erev Rav. That's what he had to come only from Am Yisrael, not from the Erev Rav. But not taken from them, they in a way stopped the influence of the Erev Rav, and the gold had to be pure. It's all a sign of how we have to do. We have to be in front of Hashem, pure like pure gold. How? Like this. If you want to, therefore, if a person did an avera, learn it for yourself. If a person did an avera, if he wants to make tshuva, he has to be pure. The intention has to be pure intention. His kavanah has to be, the tshuva has to be pure. That's how you atone for your sin. ואחר כך כסף, and after that came silver. ואין כן סדר המקרא שיחשוב זהב תחילה, ואחר כך כסף. דכתיב לי הכסף ולי הזהב. Usually it says, לי הכסף ולי הזהב. Silver to me and gold is to me. So why in reverse the order here? To show us that really the gold is an atonement for the golden calf. לפי שהיו הסודים, and also, וכאן שינה, as here was changed. וכן בהלילב. It was another person who built the Mishkan. Why? לפי שיהיו עתידים להיות עובדי עגל אחר. During the time of Malchut Israel, they built another golden calf. So in order to atone for that sin in which they're going to do, he built Eliav. לפי שישראל עודים לעשות עובדי עגל אחר, שעשה ירובעם בדן. ירובעם, king of Israel, did that in the territory of Shevet Dan. Eliav came from Shevet Dan. He was supposed to fix the other damage of the other's golden calf, which they did. That's why they took that job. And they built different things based on the, he built the inside, the other one built the outside, and that's how things were built. Da, ki Bezalel misod Shem Havaya, Bezalel comes from the attributes of Havaya, the Yudke Vavke, Lachen, Degel, Machane Yehuda, the flag of Shevet Yehuda is east. Lachen asa Bezalel. Bezalel. Tzel-el. In the shadow of God. And that is the inside. Hainu. That is the Bezalel made Yeriota Mishkan HaPnimi. The sheets, the walls of the inside of the Mishkan. V'yeriota Chitzoniot. And the external ones did Eliav. He did this on. Why? Because he came from Shevet Dan. Vedan ma'asef kol machanot. He is at the end of all the machanot. Comes at the end. Ma'asef comes at the end. And that is Shem Adnut. Shem Amonai. Velachen asa yeriot izim klipot lapri. That's why he took the ez, the goats, which became a husk for the fruit. It's all like that. That cover on the outside. And וכן בבניין הבית, בבית שלמה, that's how שלמה built it. מצד יהודה וחירם, מצד דן. צד יהודה comes to the east, and חירם comes from מצד דן, ונתחברו, and together with that, is the חיבור of שם הוויה, when we take the שם עדנות, and שם יוד כווקה, we take the יוד, we take the אלף, right? We take the hey, we take the dal, then we combine it together, we get that name that we see sometimes like that. That is the chibur, the connection, that's completely the fix-up. And now, so that was the Sodom Mishkan, Keneged HaEgel, and Benyan HaBayit is the same thing. Just one more thing, and we said yesterday, we mentioned this morning also, regarding the Kiyora Nechoshet, the sink, in which they used to sanctify the hands and legs. The Ari brings something beautiful. Hine b'shat hakravat korban, when they used to bring the korban, hakohen, the kohen would recognize in his face, makom shepagam b'machshavto. He would look at this kiyor, and the reflection would come up, and he would see where, which exactly he sinned b'machshava. He would fix it up, and they would go and be able to make. He would clean it up. He would be able to come and bring the sacrifice, because you can't bring the sacrifice unless you are clean from chataim. The same thing is a person who is an ed in a wedding. It is appropriate in order to be an ed kadosh to appropriately validate the chuppah. It is appropriate that the people would be meharer b'tshuva. They'll make tshuva for whatever they did. Ana Hashem chatanu avinu pashanu. Right? So you validate the chuppah appropriately. Here too, the korban, he's bringing a korban. The reflection from the copper, he would know where it did. He will make tshuva on that and they will be able to go make tshuva. And it says the same thing. Uveisha she'asur l'istakel befaneha, and with a woman that you're not allowed to look at her face as well, right? Hevi ota lifnei ha'kior, used to bring it in front of the kior, she'asur b'maorot ha'tzovot, that they make from those mirrors. Ve'roei sham tzurata u'makir b'machshavata v'haya menakeh chelata. So not only for himself, all for the people. When the person did an avera, exactly where he did the damage. But a woman, you're not allowed to look at a woman like that. Right, so therefore, what did he do? He used to bring it over there, and it will give her an image, almost like, let's say, a spiritual scan. It will say when he makes the, brings the korban, he used to make the kavanah to fix that stuff, and that's why it was needed. Why? Because the women sanctify the objects by the pure intention of the actions of building a bayit b'Israel. Since the action was pure, and with pure intention, it served to further generation as an ornament, as a vehicle to be able to tell the blemishes that used to, that people did when they did an avera. And all right, let's stop it here. So this is basically just like a little glimpse, really really small glimpse. I really want to speak about the neshama of Moshe Rabbeinu, how it was reincarnated in on and on and on, but that's for a different day. In a different time, and now I gotta cook for Shabbat, so I have a Shabbat Shalom and a stress-free day. Bye, Shalom.